Hello friends, this is Alamgir. Welcome to Basic Android and Electronics. Today I will show you how to make automatic pump controller circuit. This is my automatic pump controller circuit. This is the relay switch. I am switching this lamp with this relay switch. This is my 12 volt power supply. And this is the tank. The white wire connected to the bottom of this tank, and the green wire connected some upper level to the bottom, and the red wire connected to the top level of this tank. When the water down to the green wire, the pump will turn on, and when the water touch red wire, the pump will turn off. Now let's see how to work this circuit. Now I connect my power supply to the breadboard. The water pump has turned on because the tank is empty. Now load this tank. When the water touched red wire, the pump has been turned off. Now when the water down on the green wire, the pump is automatically turned on. Now again load the tank. When the tank is loaded, the pump has off. So viewers, if you want to make this project, you need NE555 IC, BC547 transistor, 2 pieces, an LED, 4.7 kΩ resistor, 2 pieces, 3.3 kΩ resistor, 1 kΩ resistor, 10 kΩ resistor, 1N4007 diode, 12 volt DC relay switch. This relay switch can operate 12 ampere 220 volt AC. Some wires, a breadboard, 12 volt power supply, and a tank for testing this circuit. You are watching Basic Android and Electronics. We are the Tiny Engineer. If you are new viewer of my channel, please tap on subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. This is the diagram for auto pump controller circuit. So let's see the making process of this circuit. Start by inserting NE555 IC to the middle of the breadboard. Connect pin 1 of the IC to the negative rail of the breadboard. Now connect pin 8 of the IC to the positive rail of the breadboard. Then connect pin 4 of the IC to the positive rail of the breadboard using 10 kΩ resistor. Now connect pin 6 of this IC to the negative rail of the breadboard. Now insert a BC547 transistor on the breadboard. Now connect pin 3 of the IC to the base of BC547 transistor by using 3.3 kΩ resistor. Then connect the emitter of BC547 transistor to the negative rail of the breadboard. Now we see the pin configuration of this relay switch. Now insert this relay switch on the breadboard. Now connect the collector of BC547 transistor to the coil terminal of this relay switch. Now connect the another coil terminal of this relay switch to the positive rail of the breadboard. Now insert another BC547 transistor on the breadboard. Now connect the emitter of this transistor to the negative rail of the breadboard. Now connect pin 4 of the IC to the collector of second BC547 transistor. Now connect an wire to the base of the second transistor by using 4.7 kΩ resistor. I am using red color wire. We need to connect this wire to the top level of the water tank. Then again connect an wire to pin 2 of the IC using another 4.7 kΩ resistor. I may use green color wire. We need to connect this wire some upper level to the bottom of the water tank. Again connect an wire to the positive rail of the breadboard. I am using white wire. We will connect this wire to the ground level of the water tank. Now connect the cathode of the LED to the collector of the first transistor. As you already know, the shorter part of LED is cathode. Then connect the anode of the LED to the positive rail of the breadboard using 1 kΩ resistor. Now switching your water pump using common pin and NC pin of the relay. For example, I am switching this lamp. Now connect the anode of on N4007 diode to the relay coil terminal, which terminal is connected to the collector of first transistor. And connect the cathode to the another relay coil terminal. The silver mark is the cathode. Now connect these three wires in the water tank. I am connected the red wire to the top level and connected the green wire some upper level to the bottom and the white wire connected to the ground level of this tank. Finally connect the 12 volt power supply to the breadboard. When I connected the power supply, the pump has turned on because the tank has no water. Now I load this tank. When the tank is fully loaded, the pump has turned off. And then when the water will down to the green wire, the pump will automatically turn on. So viewers, if you feel this video helpful, please like and share. If you have any problem or question, please comment in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe this channel and turn on the notification bell to get more tutorials. Thanks for watching.